Hi, I'm Roseanne Longo, and I'm in store today with TV celebrity chef and cookbook author Emily Richards. Today we're going to show you a really easy pie pastry so you can make your own chicken pot pie.
It's a great make-ahead pastry, and it's even quicker because we're using Longo's forest mushroom soup.
Emily, if you can get me to make my own pastry for chicken pot pie, a few simple desserts, then anybody can do this.
Perfect, let's get going.
We're back in the kitchen with Emily, and Emily, you're going to show us how easy it is to make this pie pastry.
The first thing we're going to do is start with our food processor. So in here I have some flour, salt, and sugar, and just to mix it together you can give it a little pulse. And then we're going to add some lard and butter. I like using the combination because it offers flavor as well as a really nice flaky crust. And then we'll get this back on, give it another few little pulses. And what we're looking for is the mixture to be crumbly so that we know that the butter and lard are together with the flour. Okay, so we'll just take a look in there and you can see that it's nice and crumbly, so it's ready for our liquid ingredients. So we're going to add an egg, a little bit of white vinegar, and ice cold water. Again, just to kind of keep everything nice and cold. Perfect. And then we're just going to close this back up. And what's going to happen is it's going to start to come together, and as soon as it starts to kind of create a little bit of a ball, we're going to take the lid off and stop and gather it with our hands and just create a nice little disc, wrap it with plastic wrap, and chill it in the refrigerator for about 30 minutes. So we're going to make the filling for our chicken pot pie, and we're using boneless, skinless chicken thighs. We're also going to add an onion. Get that in there.
Okay, I'll stir that in.
And some fresh thyme, and we're going to put the whole sprig in. There we go, just like that. And that's really nice because it adds lots of flavor.
It smells good.
It smells great too. So we're just going to stir it up and saute it for a couple of minutes. And then we're going to add a cup of water because we're actually going to poach the chicken in this mixture. Okay. So it really helps keep the chicken nice and tender, but it also adds a ton of flavor, which is great. So the chicken's been cooking for about 15 minutes and we're ready to add our cornstarch to thicken it. So I have a little bit of water in here as well. Okay, and then we're going to stir that all around to get it coated. And then we're going to add just some frozen mixed vegetables.
That's simple. Open a bag of vegetables.
I mean, most of us have frozen vegetables in the freezer, so it's a great way to include them. And it adds lots of color and great flavor. And then I'm going to add, this is the Longo's Forest Mushroom Soup, so it has really nice creaminess. You want to get every last drop out of the bowl.
Perfect.
And then just a little bit of black pepper, some freshly ground black pepper in there.
All right, I'll stir that all together.
And it comes together that quickly, so it's perfect. It's going to have a nice creamy texture. So we just want to set this aside to cool slightly before we put the pastry on. So I've just finished rolling out my pastry, and I'm going to roll it up on my rolling pin here and transfer it over our filling. Just like that.
You don't have to have a round pie, you can have a square pie.
I know, it makes it more fun that way. And then if you want to get a little fancy, you can crimp the sides here a little bit. Just kind of pinching it, essentially, is all you're doing. And then we're just going to make a few little vent holes in here, so that's as it's bubbling in the oven, the air will escape. And then this just gets popped in the oven till the pastry is nice and golden and the filling's good and hot. The aroma of chicken pot pie is going to fill the kitchen, and with a few simple steps, dinner is served.
It's the ultimate comfort food. My family's going to love it. For this recipe and other great meal ideas, come in store and pick up your Longo's Experience magazine or visit us online at longos.com.